A warm welcome to one and all. Myself, Dr. Rashmi Joshi Savalkar, Assistant Professor, Department of Zoology, Sri RLT College of Science, Akola. Dear friends, this is our 8th lecture of Unit 6, and today's topic is fertilizing fish ponds. So let's see what are these fertilizing fish ponds. So fertilizing fish ponds, the use of fertilizers to increase the production of natural food for fish. Fertilizers used for fish development. This is the definition that what are these fertilizing fish ponds. So let's see the introductory portion of fertilizing fish ponds. Fertilizers are natural or synthetic substances that are used in ponds to increase the production of the natural food organisms to be eaten by the fish. These organisms include phytoplankton, zooplankton, and insects. They are all part of the complex food web, converging towards fish production. Okay. By increasing the availability of major nutrients, fertilizers promote the development of planktonic algae, which provide food for many fishes. So, in this way that the planktonic algae is produced, and this algae is the food of those fishes. So, in this way the fertilizing fish ponds are constructed. So, fertilization also leads to the development of animals which feed on algae, including some fish such as the Chinese silver carp and the Nile tilapia. So, when the fertilizer is added to a fish pond, the chemicals it contains dissolve in the water. And after dissolving these fertilizers in the fish ponds, a portion is usually rapidly taken up by the phytoplanktons. The chemicals or those fertilizers are usually and rapidly taken up by the phytoplanktons present in that pond, either to be stored, sometimes in quite large proportions, or to be assimilated and used for growth, reproduction, etc. So, after adding the chemicals or fertilizers, this process happens there. Another portion is attracted by and becomes attached to the organic and mineral particles present both in the pond water and in the upper layers of the bottom mud or soil. Now, This second portion may also assist the development of bacteria responsible for the decomposition of organic matter. The decomposition of organic matter may in turn release more nutrients back into the mud or water. The chemicals attached to soil particles may also later be released back into the water slowly, over a long period of time. They may also migrate deeper into mud and soil, where they will no longer affect the water body unless the pond bottom is dried or plowed. So, after adding the fertilizers, the development of bacteria is responsible for the decomposition of organic matter. So, in the bottom of the ponds, the organic matter there is responsible for the decomposition. So, this happens very slowly unless the pond's bottom is dried or plowed. So, after washing the pond bottom completely or drying it, this process will be continued. Most of these phenomena are linked with the controlled by water quality, and in particular temperature, pH, alkalinity, and dissolved oxygen level. Now, different types of fertilizers. So, which fertilizers are used in this fish production? So, pond fertilizers form two distinct groups. There are two distinct groups in pond fertilizers: mineral or inorganic fertilizers, and the next is organic fertilizers. So, let's see what are the inorganic fertilizers, which contains only mineral nutrients and no organic matter. They are manufactured industrially to be used in agriculture for improving crop production, and they can be obtained from specialized suppliers. Now, what are organic fertilizers which contain a mixture of organic matter and mineral nutrients? They are produced locally, for example, as wastes from farm animals or an agricultural waste. So, these are all organic fertilizers. Okay, now both type of fertilizers, that means organic and inorganic, have advantages and disadvantages as listed in the table 13, which I have given in the next slide. So, let's see, select the most appropriate type of fertilization for your own needs. Selection may depend not only on local availability but also on the size of the farm. For example, first, small scale fish farms tend to rely on organic fertilizers as they are cheap and available locally. Now, large scale fish farms most often adopt inorganic fertilizers as they are more easily stored and distributed. So, the best results can often be obtained with the combined use of both types of fertilizers. Now, how the combined use of both the fertilizers, that means organic and inorganic. So, how the best result can be obtained? So, let's see comparison of organic and inorganic fertilizers. Now, see here, the first column is of items, the second is column is of organic fertilizers, and the third column is of inorganic fertilizers. So, let's see. For storage purpose, difficult not only short time. Organic fertilizers, the storage in organic fertilizers is very much difficult and it is only for short time. In inorganic fertilizers, the storage is easy, possibly for long time. Okay. Now, inorganic fertilizers, distribution is difficult, especially on larger scale, and it is very much easy for organic fertilizers. Now, mineral content in organic fertilizers are variable and low. Now, in inorganic fertilizers, consistent high to very high. Mineral content is consistent and which is high to very high. Now, organic matter is present in the organic fertilizers, which are totally absent in inorganic fertilizers. Effect on soil structure. So, organic fertilizers shows improvement in the soil structure, and there is no improvement in soil structure in inorganic fertilizers. Direct food for fish. Now, see, organic fertilizers, yes, it is the direct food for fish, and it is not the direct food for fish. The inorganic fertilizers are not the direct food for fishes. Now, decomposition process. Yes, in organic fertilization, decomposition takes place with oxygen consumption. Here, no decomposition takes place. Low to medium. Price is very low to medium in organic fertilizers and high to very high in organic fertilizers. Now, cost per nutrient unit is higher. Cost per nutrient unit is higher in organic fertilizer and it is lower in inorganic fertilizers. Availability, possibly in neighborhood or even on own farm, this organic fertilizers can be easily available, and commercial suppliers only, sometimes imported, and in organic fertilizers they are not easily available. They can be imported. Direct pond fertilization, possibly by raising animals or on near the pond, and not feasible. So, these are the comparative points, advantages and disadvantages in both the organic and inorganic fertilizers here. So, this is all about the fertilizer fish farming. So, let's see. Making the best use of fertilizers. When using fertilizers to increase fish production in your ponds, you should aim to establish and maintain a dense growth of planktonic algae and zooplankton, which should color the water a rich shade of green. Such dense planktonic growth is often called as plankton bloom. So, this is all about the organic fertilizer. To establish and maintain a good plankton bloom at minimum cost, these are the following points which are used to develop the plankton bloom at minimum cost. So, let's see. Number one, pond water and bloom soil. should be neutral or slightly alkaline. Lime them in if necessary. So this is the, these are the points. If present, bloom mud should be good quality, not too thick and mostly made of fine detritus, too much cellulose. Now reduce the competition for nutrients and sunlight. Reduce the water exchange rate and fertilize each pond. If the pond is new, the good mud has not yet formed. If the water supply is poor in nutrients, if the bottom soil is sandy rather than clay. So add more fertilizers as needed according to the plankton density using small amounts regularly if possible. So chemical qualities of a poor water supply. So what should be the chemical properties of a poor water supply? So phosphates less than 0.1 mg per liter, nitrates less than 2 mg per liter, potassium less than 0.1 mg per liter, calcium and magnesium less than 15 mg per liter. So these are the plankton density. Add more fertilizers as needed according to the plankton density using small amounts regularly if possible. So chemical qualities of a poor water supply. So these are all about the chemical qualities. Then the last point is, if supplies of fertilizer are limited, give priority to the ponds where the availability of natural food is most important. For example, nursery ponds and brood stock ponds. And then the next one is, do not fertilize a pond if. So do's and don'ts. So do not fertilize a pond if fish production does not depend on the use of natural food. The exchange rate of the water is excessive. There is too much immersed or other aquatic vegetation. The water is too muddy or dark colored and transparency is limited. The plankton turbidity is too high. So this is all about the fertilizing fish farming or fish ponds. So friends, we will stop here today and please go through the lecture and then we will take an MCQ test on this chapter. So that and if any query to you, please ask me on my WhatsApp number personally, we will discuss. Thank you.